This air that is my breath, this circling of wings that rises in me, all I know to be true, all that I am, awaits you. There is fire in this union. In this crucible we forge each other. Molten chaos and sharp edges.
Thank you.
We cross continents to leave our future. Stars and sand and soil and feathered threads that twirl and spin.
Fingers. Who are you?
Who are
the surface warm to my fingers? A solid form, an occupant of space. A makeshift kind of enjoyment. A pitiless being who runs away like water. Something left unfinished, out of inferior matter. Something God thought of. Nothing, sometimes everything.
Nothing.
Something I cannot believe in. A foolish argument.
I love
you yourself, not I.
I love
an enemy of mine.
I love
my love.
Thank you. time youths, thighs and groins, tight jean displayed, loiter onto Union Square. Junkies, flowers scattered there, lost in dream, for so fair. Young as you, old as I, voicing soundlessly, I cry. Androgyne, Mon Amour, shadows of you, name of Christ, exorbitant for sure at least. What would you suggest I do? Off slyly, off smile, off sleep, off teeth, off teeth, noise, chest, bones, through, off teeth.
confessing, choking, confessing. My tongue, not your body. My body, not yours, while murmuring you, while continually murmuring you, which is transferred to heart. It's 3 a.m. after an hour's sleep and a blonde youth who declined to stay with me. Wolf's hour of night is not well spent alone. This bit of comfort. My hands curve remembrance that remains in the memory of the unclothed, the youth who refused to stay longer. And I settle for less, perhaps. If not, somehow warmed him through and through.
I walk down the garden paths and all the daffodils are blowing and the bright blue squills. I walk down the patterned garden paths in my stiff brocaded gown. With my powdered hair and jeweled fan, I too am a rare pattern. As I wander down the garden paths, my dress is richly figured, and the train makes a pink and silver stain on the gravel and the thrift of the borders. Just a plate of current fashion tripping by in high-heeled ribboned shoes. Not a softness anywhere about me. Only whalebone and brocade. I sink on a seat in the shade of a lime tree, for my passion wars against the stiff brocade. The daffodils and squills flutter in the breeze as they please, and I weep. For the lime tree is in blossom, and one small flower has dropped upon my bosom. And the plashing of water drops in the marble fountain comes down the garden paths. The dripping never stops. Underneath my stiffened gown is the softness of a woman, bathing in a marble basin, a basin in the midst of hedges grown so thick she cannot see her lover hiding. But she guesses he is near, and the sliding of the water seems the stroking of a dear hand upon her. What is summer in a fine brocaded gown? I should like to see it lying in a heap upon the ground, all the pink and silver crumpled up on the ground. I would be the pink and silver as I ran along the path, and he would stumble after, bewildered by my laughter. I should see the sun flashing from his sword hilt and the buckles on his shoes. I would choose to lead him in a maze along the patterned paths, a bright and laughing maze for my heavy-booted lover, till he caught me in the shade. And the buttons of his waistcoat bruised my body as he clasped me, aching, melting, unafraid. with the shadows of the leaves and the sun drops and the plopping of water drops all about us in the open afternoon, I am very like to swoon with the weight of this brocade. For the sun sifts through the shade. Underneath the fallen blossom in my bosom is a letter I have hid. It was brought to me this morning by a rider from the Duke.
Madam, we regret to inform you that Lord Hartwell died in action on last Thursday night.
As I read it in the white morning sunlight, the letters squirmed like snakes.
Any answer, madam?
No. See that the messenger takes some refreshment? No. No answer. And I walked into the garden, up and down the patterned paths in my stiff, correct brocade. The blue and yellow flowers stood up proudly in the sun, each one. I stood upright too, held rigid to the pattern by the stiffness of my gown. Up and down I walked, up and down. In a month, he would have been my husband. In a month, here, underneath this line, we would have broken the pattern, he for me and I for him. He as colonel, I as lady, on this shady seat. He had a whim that sunlight carried blessing, and I answered, it shall be as you have said. Now he is dead. In summer and in winter, I shall walk up and down the patterned garden paths in my stiff, brocaded gown. The squills and daffodils will give place to pillared roses and to asters and to snow. I shall go up and down in my gown, gorgeously arrayed, boned and stayed. And the softness of my body will be guarded from embrace by each button, hook and lace, for the man who should loose me is dead, fighting with the Duke in Flanders in a pattern called a war. Christ, what a pattern's for.
Someone but where is... Yes, to the suit. But do you? And yes, I could. Oh, but
thank you.
said, Amorisi.
Some if give it especially to you. Do not forget me. Do not forget me. An unknown sphere, more real than I dreamed, more direct, dots awakening rays about me. So long, so long. Remember my words, remember my words. I may again return. I love you, I love you. I depart from materials, I am as one disembodied, triumphant dead. Disembodied mind will show me the path my heart must take to reach my rejected love.
Joyful and secure. We are the stars we see.